Hello dear students, have a good day to all. Today I am here to teach you the 8th chapter from your social science textbook. The name of the chapter is Natural Resources. In this session we are going to learn what is the meaning of resources, uses of resources, types of resources, planning and conservation of resources. First let's see what are called resources. There are thousands of elements in nature. And when these elements are used to fulfill the various needs of man, these elements are called as resources. So, resources means any element which has productivity or which help us to accomplish our needs. They are called as resources. In the ancient time, when man had no knowledge about the minerals, they were just the elements of nature which were buried within the land. But later, when man gained knowledge about minerals, he started using these minerals for various purposes. So, they are called as resources, okay, due to their utility. Thus, due to the interaction of nature, man and culture, these resources are made. Now, let's see what are the uses of resources. Resources are useful to us in many ways. Resources can be used as food, as source of raw material, and as energy resources. Now let's see how resources can be used as food. There are various resources from which we can obtain our food. We depend on many resources in order to fulfill our food requirement. Land, water, minerals, fossil fuels, biodiversity, etc. are used for the production of food. We get fruits from many trees. Agriculture provides us various types of crops. Milk and milk products, meat, etc. are obtained from domestic animals. Fish and other aquatic animals, honey by honeybees, all these are used as food items in our diet. So, we can understand that resources can be used as our food. Now, resource as source of raw materials. There are many resources on this planet which provides us raw materials for various types of industries. Say for example, woolen textile industry. So for this, wool is the main raw material. So this wool is obtained from animals and, you know, thus we can say it is a raw material for woolen textile industry. Then the hides of animals are used for leather industry. Cotton from cotton plants are raw material for cotton textile industry. Thus, there are many goods we get from nature and these are used as the raw material for various industries. Now, let's see how resources can be used as energy resources. We get many elements from nature which are used for producing energy. Energy can be generated from elements of nature like coal, petroleum, natural gas, etc. We also produce energy from wind, waves, sunlight, waterfall, etc. Thus, we can conclude that resources can be used as food, as source of raw material, and as energy resources. Hope that this part is clear to all of you. Now, let's learn the types of resources. Resources are classified on the basis of ownership, on the basis of reavailability, and on the basis of distribution. Now let's see how the resources are classified on the basis of ownership. Here you can see on the basis of ownership, resources are classified as individual resources, national resource, and global resource. Now let's see what is individual resource. The resources which are owned by an individual or a family is known as individual resources. Example, a land, a house, a vehicle, all these are individual resources. Then, national resource. National resource means, you know, the resource which are owned by a country or a region. They are called as national resource. For example, army, international trade, all this can be taken as the examples of national resource. Now, what is global resource? All types of resources which are physical or non-physical and if they are used for human welfare, they are called as global resources. the resources of common ownership of all nations of the world, such as huge oceanic water bodies, the atmosphere, outer space, all these can be taken as the examples of global resources. Now, on the basis of distribution, resources are four types. They are universal resources, the resources which are generally available, rare resources, and solitary resources. What are universal resources? Universal resources are the resources which are found everywhere in this universe. Useful gases in the atmosphere such as oxygen, nitrogen, etc. are universal resources. Now, the resources which are available easily are termed as generally available resources. For example, there are land, soil, water, pasture land, all these are easily available to all. So they are the resources which are generally available. Now, rare resources. The resources which are found or available only at some limited places are called rare resources. Example to this are minerals like coal, petroleum, copper, gold, uranium. So all these minerals are not available easily, not available everywhere. So these are found only at some places, limited places. Okay, so they are called as the rare resources. Now the last one is solitary resources. What are solitary resources? The resources which are available only at one or two places in the world are called solitary resources. Cryolite is an example to solitary resources, which is a kind of white color mineral found only in Greenland. Hope that this part is clear to all of you. Now let's see how resources are classified on the basis of reavailability. On the basis of reavailability, resources can be classified as renewable and non-renewable resources. The resources which can be reproduced naturally or can be sustained are called renewable resources. In other words, we can say they are inexhaustible resources. Example to this are solar power, wind, water, birds, etc. All these are renewable resources. Whereas there are some other resources which cannot be reproduced in near future once they are used or completed. Examples are mineral oil, coal, natural gas, petroleum, etc. are non-renewable source of energy. Once these resources are consumed, then it may take a long time, maybe millions of years, for its reproduction. So they are called as non-renewable resources of energy. Hope that it is clear. Now let's see another topic, planning and conservation of resources. It is a duty of all of us to conserve these resources, because there are some resources which are non-renewable. That means once they get consumed fully, it may take another millions of years for its reproduction. Then our future generation may live without these resources. So we have to use these resources very rationally, and we should take some measures for its conservation. Conservation means if any resource is facing a danger of existence, say for example if a tree or a human life is facing danger, then some arrangement has to be made for its protection, and this is called conservation. So while planning for conservation, we have to keep certain points in mind, and these points are as follows. First of all, gather information about the availability of utilized or unutilized resources of any particular region. Then, second point is use scientific method for its exploitation and use the non-renewable resources only when it is necessary to use. Third point, make attempts to increase the quantity of resources. Then, we should not waste the resources which are easily available. Instead, use it judiciously. Then find an alternative resource for the resources which are in limited quantity. Find a substitute for that. Next is frame laws for the conservation of resources. and these laws should be implemented strictly. The last point is create public awareness. You know, more than everything, a public awareness should be cultivated so that the conservation of these resources can be done. Hope that these topics are clear to all of you. So let us wind up the session here today. Please read the chapter thoroughly from your textbook. We'll continue this chapter in the next session. Until we meet, take care. Bye.